channel sometimes. I've done it before. I build a puzzle. I'm like hilariously bad at building puzzles, so we'll see. This puzzle is, I don't know if you can see it, I'm kind of far away, but it's a Dr. Seuss puzzle. I'll show you guys at the end if it turns out, if I don't have to give up. Sometimes I give up. But, yeah. So, we're getting towards the end of the month, which is pretty exciting. I hope you guys have liked getting all these extra videos. Everybody's May been. I do apologize for any extra background noise. It's because the AC is on, and that's because it's hot here in New York right now. It's like in the 90s. The low 90s, but still quite warm. You guys, how's everything going? Let me know in the comments down below. If you didn't see my last video, it was like a bitchy roleplay, which is one of my favorite kinds of ASMRs to watch. So, it was really fun to film it, actually. So I hope you guys like it. It doesn't have so many views, but I think that could be because I uploaded it at like a weird time. So I uploaded it like after midnight, so maybe everybody was already sleeping, I don't know. But if you haven't seen it, I'll link it below. I had to show my friends, like, because I was like proud of it. Look. did you guys eat at barbecues this weekend? Or go on any trips? I went to Long Island. That's in New York. Oh my goodness, I think I finished this puzzle so quickly. Okay, I'm gonna go grab another puzzle so we can do another one. I'm going to first break down this puzzle. Video to watch. So, this story starts in, I was in 8th grade, and I woke up in the middle of the night. It was the night before 8th grade testing. If you guys are around my age, because I don't know, I think they changed it, I don't know. My mom is talking to her mom or whatever, and she's like, She's like, this sounds messed up. Like, this is, I feel like this isn't right. If you're doing, if it was acid reflux, then why are you still experiencing this pain when you do everything right? She's like, listen, my neighbor is like,
bad.
cool. Let's do the surgery right now. Oh, another fun fact is that I was, I was at a teaching hospital. So when I went in, they were like, they gave me all this paperwork, literally me, even though I was a minor. I guess my mom probably had decided to. But they were like, can we film your surgery? Can we have people watch your surgery so they can learn? I was like, sure, I don't care. I'm like, sign, I don't care. Like, it's like Grey's Anatomy or whatever. They can, the interns can learn off of me. I'll be your guinea pig. It's all cool. So then I'm about to go in for my surgery and they're like, yeah, you have to get like buck naked. Like, you have to be 100% naked. I was like, I can't, like, there is no reason I should be naked. Like, I should at least be able to have underwear on. You're not even going anywhere down there. Because it was supposed to be a laparoscopic surgery. So I could just, like, they're supposed to go in through your belly button just for like an hour. So, I was like freaking out about that. I really did not want to have everything like video. I'm a 15-year-old girl, keep in mind. And I did not want like a videotape of me just naked. So, I was like freaking out. And they were like, oh my god, she's freaking out. She's having anxiety about the surgery. But that's not what it was about. I was fine with the surgery, but I was not fine with Ninky. But then they were like, well, here's some drugs. They just shot me up with these anti-anxiety drugs, so I was all zonked out. And then that's kind of the last thing I remember, but I do remember fighting for underwear until I got some. Then they gave me like this mesh like thing for me to put on, and then I was happier. So I go under for surgery. It's supposed to be 1 hour laparoscopic surgery, and like 4 hours later I'm still not out of surgery. And they're like, they didn't update my parents at all. So my mom's like, oh god, she dead. No, I don't know, but it kind of, I would think she was really worried. Oh, just so much pain. And like the nurses are all like crowding around me, like freaking out. Like I see their faces, like they're like, what the heck is going on with this girl? So I was like, great, I'm a goner. But I was like, I was also really, really like on a lot of the pain, like morphine or whatever they give me. So like I would like look up, see their face, see them freaking out, and then like pass back out. And then like wake up and like they'd be like, we need to move her, we need to do this, blah blah blah, we need to call the doctor back, blah blah blah. And I'd be like, just pass back out. So turns out that when you have a surgery, they like on the inside of your body, they take a like tube and put it from the inside, like where your incisions are, goes to the outside of your body. So anything like any of the stuff, you know, like that's dripping out is not just like dripping into your body and causing any damage. Like they have it, you know, collecting it and coming out of the drainage tube. And then there's like a little bag that's like attached to you and that like collects all that stuff. But the tube from the outside of my body was connected to the bag, came apart from the bag, and then the tube part, like, instead of sticking out, because then that would have been fine, you know, would have been just draining out into, like, the bed, it slipped back inside my body. So there's this just, like, rogue tube inside my body, and so they had to get the doctor back and, yeah, go back in, get the thing out of me. Chester, so he had to come all the way back. So then, you know, recovery took a couple weeks, but I don't think there was any really more bumps in the road. It was hard for me because I was 15 and I think I was like a little, I wasn't mature enough to handle the situation, so like I was very embarrassed that like everybody saw, like I wasn't able to get up and go like get up to use the bathroom or anything like that. So like there's people, like the nurses and everything, I just had to like basically be myself. And I don't know, I was like, to me that was so devastating and so embarrassing at the time. And now it's like, girl, you just had like major surgery, so you do what you gotta do. That's what I would say to little me. But yeah, so that's my story. I ended up like missing a month of school, or like 3 weeks, and then I came back after Christmas break, and I was really behind in all my classes, so I had to get a tutor. But then I caught up and everything was fine. I was too focused on telling you guys this story and I forgot to build this puzzle, but this puzzle is really hard, so I think I'm gonna give up on it. But I'll see you guys in the next. Everything worked out in the end. I'm fine. I'm healthy. And I got rid of a body part that was